means witnessing is an action word. As we've received Christ, it is our duty to witness to the people of all nations and to witness unto the people of all nations. Witnessing simply means telling others what we have personally experienced of the Lord Jesus. In the book of Psalm 107, verse 2, it says, this is God just admonishing us by saying, let the redeemed of the Lord say so, whom he had delivered from the hand of the adversary. Who is our adversary? Does anyone know the adversary of our lives? The devil. So Satan, Lucifer, is the adversary. He has taken sin into the world to make us shy away from God and not to make us be God's pride. So God is telling us this evening, be my pride and also make men my pride. 1 Timothy chapter 2 verse 4 tells us the God's mission on earth. And Bishop has categorically said this time to that number that said, God's mission on earth is to have all men to be saved and to come unto the knowledge of the truth. Who will have all men to be saved and to come to the knowledge of the truth? This is by us doing what? By witnessing for Christ, by telling people a salvation story, by telling people what the Lord has done in our lives. And first thing I want us to talk about this evening, is why should we witness? It is our mandate. You know, earlier on I talked about the mandate of this ministry, that we should be God's pride and to make men God's pride. So God himself also mandated us. He gave us the authority when he died and he went to it. He released all the saints that were in Sheol and he unhinged the gates of hell and released all the saints and made them go to heaven. That was when he died and he resurrected. So he's saying that in Matthew chapter 28 verse 19, Jesus Christ said, go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. This is like God telling us that go into the world, preach my gospel to all men, and baptize them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. Also in Mark chapter 16 verse 15, are we following this? Also in Mark chapter 16 verse 15, God said, go ye into the world and preach the gospel to every creation. He didn't say just preach the gospel to only Alexia or just Modupe. He said preach the gospel to everybody you meet. Talk to them about Jesus Christ. Engage everyone with that bias. Don't be like, this guy is a Muslim, I cannot talk to him. Or this one, she does not greet me, I'm not going to talk to her about Jesus. He has mandated you. He gave you the authority. He gave you an order to preach the gospel to all men. And that's the first one I said, it is our mandate. So that's the first reason why we should witness to God. The second reason why we should be a witness for Christ is that the kingdom of Satan loses. We all know that Satan's mission is to keep people under his evil authority. But when people believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, they are delivered from Satan's power. So in John chapter 10 verse 10, this is just telling us about what Satan is doing. Satan, he said, the thief cometh not but for to steal and to kill and to destroy. That is Satan's mission. But God is saying that I come that they might have life. Through us, people, we have life in Jesus Christ. Through us, people will have life in Jesus Christ. And that they might have it more abundantly. That people might have life because the devil has come to steal and to destroy. But God came to the world. He died for our sins. He resurrected on the third day for us to have life in him. And to have life abundantly. Not just life, but abundant life. Also, in Acts chapter 26 verse 18, Paul was speaking and he said, to open their eyes and to turn them from darkness. Who is darkness? Satan. Satan is darkness. He said, to open their eyes and turn them from darkness to light, and from the power of Satan unto God, that they may receive forgiveness of sins and inheritance among them which are sanctified by faith that is in me. That is, once you preach the word of God to somebody, it is not by merely preaching. Your actions, how you behave at work, how you relate with people, through that they might, there is every tendency for them to give their life to Christ through your actions. So he said that they may be moved from darkness unto light. The third reason why we should witness is because the unbelievers need to hear the gospel. In Romans chapter 1 verse 14, Paul called himself a debtor. So the fact that you were saved, that somebody preached the gospel to you, where would you be if nobody ever preached the gospel of Christ to you? So that means the fact that you've been saved and you've received God as your personal Lord and Savior, you are also a debtor to bring more people to Christ. I remember when I was small, people, they will tell you that the more people you preach to, the more crowns, the more gold that will be added to your crown. So as you are preaching the word, you should know that you're a debtor and you must fulfill that mandate that I earlier talked about. So the next thing I'll be talking about, I already talked about why we should witness. That is the reason why we should witness for Christ. And now we're going to witness for Christ. The first thing to do is to consecrate yourself to the Lord. Let us open our Bibles to Romans 6, 11, verse 2, 14. Romans 6, 11 to 14, please. It reads, likewise, reckon ye also yourself to be dead unto sin. When you want to consecrate yourself to God, you have to be dead to sin, totally dead to sin, but alive unto God through Jesus Christ our Lord. If the NKJV version has this heading that says dead to sin, alive in Christ, that's the heading on NKJV version of the Bible. Verse 12 says, let not sin therefore reign in your mortal body, because your body is what? Your body is the temple of God. That ye should obey it in the lust thereof. Do not obey lust, consecrate yourself to the Lord. Verse 13 says, neither yield ye your members as instruments of unrighteousness unto sin, but yield yourselves unto God as those that are alive from the dead, and your members as instruments of righteousness unto God. This is just saying, consecrate. It's a simple order. Do not let sin take charge over your life. You've given your life to Christ, and you are still abiding in sin. You need to consecrate yourself totally to God Almighty for you to be able to witness unto people. Because if your life is filled with sin, how then can you witness to people? Another thing you need to do, like another thing, another way by which you can witness to people is to pray for them. You necessarily do not need to be in a physical space with people before you can witness for them, intercede for them, ask God, you can actually make a list of people in your office that you know they do not believe in Christ, of people in your family that you know do not believe in Christ, and tell God, God, how do you want me to go about this? How do you want me to speak your word? When? Because the timing is everything. Lord, lead me aright. Let me preach your word to them at the right time so that they will have the understanding of your word. Another way by which you can witness for Christ is by sharing your salvation story. You don't need to go to a theological school to share your salvation story. The assurance you have is, I have been saved. So whatever I say is of the Lord. And I'm going to witness to people. I'm going to tell people that the Lord has been good to me. The Lord has saved my soul. And that way by which you can witness for Christ is to use your talent to witness. Do you know how to sing? Do you know how to draw? Anything, whatever God has given each and every one talents by which we can witness to him. So whatever talent it is that God has given to you, use it to witness to God. The most important thing that I feel as Christians we should imbibe in witnessing to God is our lifestyle. You cannot say, you cannot be filled with different things and say, people will even look at you, look at the person coming to witness, look at the person coming to tell me about Christ. You that's at work, you are so proud, you do not greet people, you do not relate to people, you are so filled with different things, and you say you want to witness. How would people then talk to you and accept what you are giving them? So you need to change your lifestyle and make your lifestyle that of Christ. He said, alive in Christ, be like Christ, be like Jesus. I pray that we'll be empowered to witness to God in Jesus' name. I pray that the Lord will fill us with the Spirit to witness in Jesus' name. And I pray that whatever thing is in our lives that is not making the glory of the Lord reflect in our lives, that is not making people change their ways, even by looking at our character, the Lord will change us in Jesus' name. So this evening, I'm going to leave us with two things. It was what Bishop shared 2 Sundays ago. He said, in James chapter 4, verse 17, therefore, to him that knoweth to do good, and doeth it not, to him it is sin. Your life might be perfect. You might have a perfect lifestyle. You might not be in sin. But then, the fact that you are not witnessing, you know that God has given you a mandate to witness, but then you are not witnessing. That means you are still in sin. So you need to witness to God. You need to do what is right. You need to fulfill your mandate, why God has created you. You need to use your talent to talk to Jesus, to talk to people about the gospel of Christ. Also, in Isaiah chapter 6, verse 8, it says, and I read, also, I heard the voice of the Lord saying, whom shall I send? And who will go for us? Then I said, here I am, send me. So I want us to go with these two passages and go home and reflect upon it. And then we should ask God, is there whatever way you want me to serve you, whatever way you want me to witness, Lord, direct me. Lord, send me. Lord, I yield myself to you as we rise and pray. Let's pray, please. without say, God, send me, Lord, send me. Father, Lord, I yield myself to you. Oh, Lord, help me to fulfill my mandate because you have died on the cross of Calvary for me. And you instructed me to go ye therefore into all nations and preach your gospel. Let us begin to pray. Let us pray. Let us pray. We are not praying. Let us pray. It might be like a trivial thing, but it's the mandate that God wants us to do. It is the most important thing that the Lord has placed in our hearts, that we should preach the word of God to all people. That we should preach to all people that they may see light, that they may move from darkness unto light, that the veil upon their eyes might be opened, that they may see that the Lord is their God and Savior. And I sing, I the Lord of seasons stars. Please pray. I have heard my people's cry. Who will bear my word to them? Here I am, Lord, it is I, Lord, I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me. God, I will hold your people in my heart. I will preach your gospel to them. They are in darkness and I will bring light unto them. Tell it to God, Father Lord, lead me aright. Oh Lord, direct me. Oh Lord, help me. Oh Lord, help me to yield myself to you. For in Jesus' mighty name have I prayed. Father Lord, you will empower us from this time moving on, that we will be empowered in Jesus' name. We will preach your gospel to all generations, and through us people will see the light in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, I pray that this evening through us people will see the light in Jesus' name. Let's be seated in God's presence. As I welcome the anointed minister that is using our voice to witness to God, that is using our voice to minister to the people of God. You are welcome, ma'am. Please come on stage.